Yes, Isha, please stand up and tell me what we have read in the chapter. Which chapter are we reading? Please inform the class. We're reading the address. What have we read in it? What is this chapter about? Before the war and after the war. Okay. Yes, sit down. Next, Smriti. Yes, can you tell me something about this chapter? Yes. Yes. Very good, very good. At least she remembers something. Sit down. Yes, Megha. At the given address, or the mother had emphasized again and again that you need to remember this address. Yes. And sit down. What happens when she reaches that place? What did she notice? Yes, Khushi? Yes. Yes. She noticed that her belongings were used by the owner. Sit down. How did that change things? They were her things, her mother's belongings. So what if they were used by somebody else? But how did that change things? Yes, Garv? How did it change things? Aditya, can you sit straight? It didn't change anything. She was very happy to see her belongings being used. Maybe in the last period it was there. Yes, was she happy to see all the things being used like that? Sit down. So Garv also has not read the chapter, right? He was not attentive. Yes, Khushi? So they were not used in the proper manner. Okay, fine. Sit down. So why is it, what does it matter here? What were the things that she noticed being used? First of all, when the lady opened the door, she saw her wearing the cardigan, right? Second time she goes back. Yes. What are the things that she noticed? Have you read that part or not? No, we have not read that part. Now, what we are going to read here is that, you know, all these things that we talk about, the cardigan, we're talking about the plates, we're talking about the candle stand, right? Might talk about other, you know, like, yes, so whether it's about the plates, both antique and new ones here, why do we give so much importance to materialistic things? Why were these things, they're just things, aren't they? Why were they so important? Because they were memories, yes. And do you remember what was the address mother told her to remember? Yes, it was 46 or 45? 46, sorry, I always, again, it's 46 Markney Street, isn't it? And who was the lady? Mrs. Darling. How does she introduce herself, the young lady? She introduces herself as Mrs. S.'s daughter. Okay, right. Yeah. So what were the things that she had noticed? Sorry, that is here. Whenever she would go there, she noticed that in her house, some things were missing. And one day she actually saw the lady taking this huge suitcase full of their belongings out of their house. And what does mother tell her? What is the reason that she says? That she's keeping them safe, right? And yes, yeah, so she's going to keep them safe. And when they need them, is she going to return them? Yes, that is what mother thought. But do you think that is going to happen? No, it is not going to happen. I have six, seven heads shaking. because they're the ones who have read the chapter, who are attentive. Others don't even bother to bring their books. You are in the offline class now. I'm not sharing the screen with you all. Clear? And tomorrow onwards, I do not want to see anyone without the book. So which book are we reading? Which are we doing? Snapshots. Okay? We're going to start with this first. Okay? So let's finish this chapter and the next one. And then we'll come to the next book. Okay? Right? Yes, so page 11, 12. So open to page 12. This is where we were reading? Yes? So it's been quite some time and you've forgotten, is it? Right? So we can just start again here. Let's look at page 12 here, all of you. My mother, from the first line, my mother seemed to notice that I was not entirely convinced. She looked at me reprovingly, and after that, we spoke no more about it. What is it that the daughter was not convinced about? That she will keep her belongings safe and she will return them when the time comes, okay? Meanwhile, I had arrived at the station without having paid much attention to things on the way. So things are going to be mentioned again and again. So where had the daughter gone to? She had gone to the address which had been mentioned. Now she's coming back and she's recollecting all the events, right? All the memories that she has and how her mother had told her to remember that address. I was walking in familiar places again for the first time since the war, but I did not want to go further than was necessary. So, what do you think has happened after the war? What has happened now? Why has she come back? To collect her things, right? And why does she talk about familiar things? She wants to be in places that are known to her. So she's gone to that lady's house. She's coming back. She did not notice much on the train. But she realizes that this area, this part of the city I'm familiar with, she does not want to go further than that, right? So already a lot has happened in her life. What is the loss that she has suffered? Yes, what loss has she suffered? Anyone can answer this, I think so, if you're listening. The loss of her family, right? She survived the war and she's now trying to bring her life back on track, right? So she is only sole survivor. But I did not want to go further than was necessary. I didn't want to upset myself with the sight of streets and houses full of memories from a precious time. Time when she was with her family. And now the time has changed. So she thinks that she's going to be very, very upset. In the train back, I saw Mrs. Darling in front of me again, as I had the first time I met her. Who's Mrs. Darling? Yes, the lady who has a mother's belongings, right? So she is Mrs. Darling. As I had the first time I met her, it was the morning after the day my mother had told me about her. So now the memories are going back and forth, right? So yes, so she's saying that how she saw Mrs. Darling and that time mother had told her about that how this lady is going to keep their belongings, right? I had got up late and coming downstairs, I saw my mother about to see someone out. A woman with a broad back. So this is what all she has seen of her. She did not remember much of her. There is my daughter, said my mother. She beckoned to me. The woman nodded and picked up the suitcase under the coat rack. She wore a brown coat and a shapeless hat. So nothing much was visible of her, right? So, does she live far away? I asked, seeing the difficulty she had going out of the house with a heavy case. What was there in the heavy case? Mother's belongings. So is she talking about the past or present here? She's talking about the past. Was it before the war or during the time of the war, right? Or you can say it before the things became out of hand, right? In Markani Street, said my mother, number 46. Remember that. So what was the address she had to remember? 46 Markani Street. Who lived there? Mrs. Darling. Okay. Yes. I had remembered it, but I had waited a long time to go there. Initially, after the liberation, I was absolutely not interested in all that stored stuff. What does liberation here refer to? Liberation from what? Liberation from the German forces, the German troops. Yes, so when the, troops had been sent back. So liberation means what? What do you think liberation means? You talk about liberty. You talk about liberation. What is it? Freedom? Yes. So when freedom was there, when were these people free? When the forces, when the troops, they went back. Okay, so they left a country. I was absolutely not interested in all that stored stuff. And naturally, I was also rather afraid of it. Why would she be afraid of the stored stuff? Why was she afraid of it? What would happen when she would look at those things? Memories. And they would make her even more sad, isn't it, right? And bring back memories of the past. It would bring back memories of her family. Are you listening, Kunal? Okay. Afraid of being confronted with things that had belonged to a connection that no longer existed, which were hidden away in cupboards and boxes and waiting in vain until they were put back in their place again, which had endured all those years because they were things. Is there anything ironical about these lines? What does ironical mean? How are things more permanent than human beings? Things survive longer? Yes. And what happens to us? We are mortals, right? And yes, here, how had the war affected her family? There was a big loss, but the things had survived. So why is she talking about things again? Things here when she was there traveling, right? Coming back in the train. Things here which her mother had kept safely so that they could be used again, right? So why is she afraid to look at those things? Because they would bring back memories. They would make her hurt, right? They would make her even more emotionally upset. Yes, weak also. But gradually, everything became more normal again. So liberation took place. What do you think are the problems that people face after the war? After the war. Yes? Yeah, loss of houses, you're saying, yeah. Food shortage, okay. Loss of near and dear ones. Shelters are lost. Trust is lost. Yes, we lose that. It's very difficult to get that faith back. What about it? Do you think the war is over and after that, do you think, okay, fine, I have to go back to work. I have to go back to my office. I have to go back to my school and college. Will those things function like they did earlier? Will it take time? It will take time. Things are going to take time to return to normal routine, right? So she's also saying that, yeah, so, things that we take for granted, you know, like whether it's about bread and milk and sugar, right? Even like the fruits and vegetables, how they're rationed. So they're not so freely available that you can go and buy anything in the market. So there is the fear of bombing, there's the fear of the enemy. You have to make sure that you are safe. And it could be quite possible that members of your family, they have gone to fight in the war. Right? Yes. So here it is that. So things, it takes a long time to come back to normal, right? Things are not easily available. So bringing all that trade back on track, bringing the economy back on track, bringing our lives back here, right? Making things function again. Gradually, everything became more normal again. Bread was getting to be a lighter color. There was a bed you can sleep in unthreatened. A room with a view you were more used to glancing at each day. That means during the war, she did not even have a permanent shelter, right? So now there is stability also. And one day I noticed, I was curious about all the possessions that must still be at the address. I wanted to see them, touch, remember. So one day she just realized that, yeah, I wanted those things. And so she wanted to go back to the address. And yes, so how long does it take us to overcome loss, to become emotionally strong again? How long does it take? Yes? It takes a lot of time, right? But sooner or later, we have to face that loss. We have to accept reality. And what will happen if we don't move on? Who are we going to end up hurting? Yes, Sir Simran, what's funny? Move on has other meanings also. Oh, really? We're talking about the chapter right now. Let's talk about the chapter. That's more relevant. So why is it important to move on in life in all conditions? Yes? Neend khul gayi. Yes? Because we have to accept the reality. And if we don't accept the reality, we're going to end up hurting ourselves only. Right? So you need to get back, you need to get back to your studies, you need to get back to work, you need to get back on with your life. Keep yourself busy, keep yourself occupied. No one is ever going to replace the loss of your near and dear ones. That is going to be there, a distant memory. Right? But yes, life goes on, life does not stop. That is what we have to realize. And one day I noticed, I was curious about all the possessions that must still be at that address. I wanted to see them, touch, remember. So now maybe she is emotionally ready to face the reality. So she is now ready that yes, to accept the loss of her family. So she wanted to see those things and accept them as a part of her life. After my first visit in vain to Mrs. Darling's house, I decided to try a second time. When did she go the first time? What happened the first time when she went to Mrs. Darling's house? Was she allowed to enter the house? No. And the lady did not welcome her in the house. And yes, so she pretended as if she did not recognize her. But how was this lady very sure I've come to the right address? Because what did she saw her wearing? The cardigan. Very nice. Yes, so she saw her wearing her mother's cardigan. So she was sure I've come to the right address. So what do you think in vain means? The first effort was in vain. It was futile. It was not fruitful. Okay? Right. Yes, so I decided to try a second time. Now a girl of about 15 opened the door to me. So who's opened the door the second time? A young girl. I asked her if her mother was at home. No, she said my mother's doing an errand. So she's doing some little jobs of the house. No matter, I said, I'll wait for her. I followed the girl along the passage. An old-fashioned iron Hanukkah candle holder hung next to a mirror. So what is that? It's a candle holder, generally, which is found in Jewish homes, right? Next to a mirror. We never used it because it was much more cumbersome than a single candlestick. What do you think cumbersome means? Cumbersome, right? Because it was so big and so elaborate, right? It was not just one candle. We could put many candles. So it was very difficult to carry, to manage. And lighting one candle is much easier, right? So cumbersome. So quite heavy, difficult, right? Won't you sit down? Asked the girl. She held open the door of the living room and I went inside, Pastor. How is this, reaction different from her mother's? Would her mother allowed her inside? No. She would not have wanted to come inside and see what she's done with their things, right? So the daughter is unaware of it. She does not even know this young lady, right? I stopped horrified. What all has she seen in the entrance? What did she see? The candle stand. Now she has entering the room. She's horrified. I was in a room I knew and did not know. How? How was it that she knew the room? Because of the belongings. And how did she not know the room? Because she has come to a different place, right? She's come to a different house. Very good. I found myself in the midst of things I did want to see again, but which oppressed me in the strange atmosphere. What does oppress mean? Oppress means, oppression to control here. So oppress here also, it seems as if she was feeling very suffocated and very upset in this very strange atmosphere. Why is everything so strange over here? Because what does she notice around her? Her mother's things, right? So she's shocked. That is why she says, I was horrified. Or because of the tasteless way everything was arranged. What does this mean? Tasteless way everything was arranged. Do you think things were put properly? The way they should have been? No, so tasteless. Because of the ugly furniture or the muggy smell that hung there, because maybe that room might not be opened or sunlight does not come there. So that musty smell that you have, okay? I don't know, but I scarcely dared to look around me. The girl moved a chair. I sat down and stared at the woolen tablecloth. I rubbed it. My fingers grew warm from rubbing. I followed the lines of the pattern. Somewhere on the edge, there should be a burn mark that had never been repaired. So what about the tablecloths? Whom did it belong to? Her mother. So why was she very familiar with it? So she was able to trace the pattern and she knew that the burn mark, do you think that burn mark had been there earlier also? Yes. And no one had bothered to? Yeah, mend it, right? So nobody had bothered to take care of it. So they're using it like that, okay? So we'll finish here. We continue tomorrow. Yes, Navya, beautifully written. Yeah, things also endure, right? Very nice. Okay, yes, yeah, I've announced the project for you all. Start working on it. End of November is okay? Before your PT3. Fine, be ready with it.